as you can see, probably next bit over here, you can see how fast our algorithm is able to train. So the most computationally expensive and time demanding step of any deep learning process is the training step, where you are iteratively going over your data set and trying to learn from it. This step is done incredibly fast with IBM's Power AI system. And if we wait for a minute, we'll also see the outputs. Oh yeah, and just for those of you who want to know a little bit more about this particular demonstration. Oh yeah, anyway, there we go. So we have something called a loss function, which measures the error on of our particular neural network. And over here, as you can see, the loss is going down. There's essentially this algorithm called a gradient descent, which is used to reduce the error of your neural networks. And finally, we evaluate our neural network and see that we have 98% accuracy. This is quite common in the MNIST dataset. It's a solved problem and it's quite easy. Yeah, and over here, this last bit over here is executing a little bit on the test dataset, and as you can see, we have the images over here, and our model is able to correctly classify these particular images as handwritten digits. For example, you can see over here, there's a picture of 0 and the model predicts 0. So yeah, that was a little bit on Power AI and convolutional neural networks, but deep learning is much more than that. We have very interesting algorithms and research being done right now in deep learning. A particularly interesting example that I found recently was the deepfakes algorithm. What this algorithm does is it swaps out a person's face from a video with another person's face. So this is commonly used, like right now, in applications where let's say swapping out an actor, the face of an actor in a movie with your favorite actor. So people have done this algorithm and they've got quite reasonable results, and you can find many more examples online of the deepfakes algorithm. But one particularly lucrative application that I found for this was in computer graphics. So over here we have a few images from a game called FIFA 18, which is a soccer game. And over here, so what we're doing over here is swapping between the two faces, cycling and forth. So the image that looks less professional is actually the computer generated imagery that's used in this particular game. But what the author of a blog post that I read recently, what he did was, he used the deepfakes algorithm and he trained it on real images of these particular soccer players. And what he was able to do is actually considerably improve the quality of the computer generated graphics. I find this particularly interesting application of this particular algorithm, as it can provide huge improvements in animation and game design industries. Another interesting research paper that was done recently was the DensePose algorithm, which was created by a team of researchers within the Facebook AI research team. And it's quite self-explanatory through the video, but what you're essentially doing is mapping out the individual pixel values of a human in a particular video, and you create UV surface coordinates of these people. And what you can also do is, once you've created the mapping of the human body based on a pure video, you can actually swap these out for interesting, that you can probably add a hat or something. And this is a little bit more the details on how exactly the DensePose system works, but we're not going to focus on that today. So what's next for AI and deep learning? So as of now, many people believe that computer vision is a solved problem. This is because computer vision involves static data. The images are of a fixed size in most cases, and even if the images are not of a fixed size, we can pad the images and make every image out there of a standard format, a standard size of a matrix. And currently, we have incredible algorithms out there for computer vision, and we've seen greater than